Papa 40 and check your rollies, it's Pepsi or Papo, a dude with attitude, and today I'm coming at you with another WWE 2K23 DLC review. This time it's the Pretty Sweet Pack. We're going to go through everything in this review like we did our previous review. Really excited for this pack though, as we get not only two tag teams, but we also get a women's wrestler from NXT. But we're going to start this out the same way we started the other one, with opening the Pretty Sweet My Faction Pack. Let's get that out of the way, and let's see what we got. We got Kit Wilson and Elliot Prince, both gold 68s. We got Carl Anderson and Luke Gallows, sapphire. I'm glad they are sapphire. And, of course, Tiffany Stratton, 77, Sapphire. So we get three Sapphires with this one. Honestly, I think this might have been better than the last one with my faction. Not too shabby. Alright, so these are their renders, same as the My Faction cards, which is fine. I gotta be honest, I don't know about Pretty Deadly, because like I said, I don't know too much about them. I've only seen them twice, but I gotta be honest, I like Luke Gallows and Carl Anderson stuff, because one, if you decided to break them up as a tag team, their renders here are pretty neutral to where they could be a heel or a face, and they could definitely be on their own. It doesn't scream the club, and that's what I like. So if you wanted to break these guys up and have them have a singles career, that's pretty good. We are going to see what the commentary is like. So I am going to mute myself. We're going to watch both teams' entrances, listen to the commentary, as well as watch both victory scenes and see some action and see how these guys look as a tag team.
The most extravagant, flamboyant, eccentric, and gorgeous team in WWE history.
The following contest is a tag team match set for one fall, and is for the WWE World Tag Team Championship! On the way to the ring, at a combined weight of 357 pounds, Elton Prince and Kid Wilson, Pretty Deadly!
Here's a team who are completely in sync with each other. The epitome of teamwork.
Yeah, they're also in sync when it comes to annoying their opponents as well.
Yes, boy!
Stop saying that.
Come on, Byron, give me one. Yes,
boy! Not. No, I'm not saying it, Corey.
Do it. Do it.
Proof that looks can be deceiving.
Oh, come on, Cole. Don't judge a book by its gorgeous cover. You try, Cole. Yes, boy! Come on, Cole. Please?
Don't say it, Michael. Don't say it.
These two are all about beating people up and winning gold.
And they have won gold all over the world.
Their opponents at a combined weight of 505 pounds. Carl Anderson and Luke Gallows, the OC!
Already cemented their legacy as one of the greatest tag teams in the world.
You're right, Cole, and that's why the tag team division has been on notice since their return.
You can see the look of intensity on their faces already. The fun and games are over.
I am not envious of their opponents at all. They're in store for an old-fashioned butt-whooping, guys.
All right, guys, so now that you got to see them in actual gameplay and whatnot, let's see what their victory motions would be without the titles.
Here are your winners, Elton Prince and Kid Wilson, Pretty Deadly. Carl Anderson and Luke Gallows, the OC.
All right, so one thing I want to point out is that the OC had two different victory motions, one for face and one for heel. I think that they gave him a new victory motion just because they hadn't been in the game. And because of that, they decided to give him a new thing, but they left the other one in. So I like that. Lastly, we will see the victory motion for the entire OC.
Paul Anderson, Luke Gallows, and AJ Styles, the OC.
Now that is pretty much the same, but they did get an updated actual entrance, which we're just going to watch that entrance.
The following contest is a six-man tag team match. On the way to the ring, at a combined weight of 723 pounds, AJ Styles, Luke Gallows, and Carl Anderson, the OC.
The tension building for this match is so thick you can cut it with a knife. A lot of drama involved with this one.
All right, now before we move on to see all the moves and go into the overall thoughts and all that stuff, we have to see Tiffany Stratton's entrance and all her stuff as well.
Oh joy, it's Daddy's little princess.
The following is scheduled for one fall, making her way to the ring. From Prior Lake, Minnesota, Tiffany Stratton.
She was a standout gymnastics athlete turned in-ring competitor.
Impressive how she's adapted.
Oh, she had the best training that money can buy. There is no shortcut Tiffany Stratton won't take. Always likes to go the easy route.
Well, that just shows her intelligence, Saxton. Why take risks if you don't have to?
Stratton thinks she deserves the top spot here.
Delivered by Tiffany Stratton. Now Stratton all the way up to the top.
What a move by Stratton.
Can Mia come back from that? Two count.
Here is your winner, Tiffany Stratton.
A big win for her. And she certainly earned it.
She worked hard for this win, and now she gets to enjoy the payoff.
Absolutely. You love to see someone's determination come to fruition like this.
Okay, now we're going to go look at some of the moves, and we're going to use Tiffany Stratton to do that, mainly because I didn't get to see her signature with the springboard swanton. In that gameplay, you didn't get to see it. For some reason, it just wouldn't work. Maybe that's a glitch, or I don't know. I don't know if this is actually new either, but it looks pretty cool. BME is already in the game, but the Corksaw Stratton Bomb, her own move, looks pretty solid. They added this for Luke Gallows. I think this is new, but I don't know who it would be for. Part of me thinks maybe Luke Gallows. A new Gallows Pole. They updated his finisher. It's not much different than the other one, but I don't know. I always like it when they update them. And this one definitely looks more realistic. I think the Leaping Back Elbow is new. The Liger Bomb is definitely new. And this is definitely new. And I believe it's also Luke Gallows. This is the new Spine Buster for Carl Anderson. And I gotta be honest, I like it. I might even add that to Triple H's. I think it's better than Triple H's Spine Buster. How is that a Tilt-A-Whirl side slam? What? They didn't add as much moves as they did last time, which is disappointing. The taunts were pretty disappointing this time. But I will say for the Pretty Deadly, they're pretty spot on. Tiffany Stratton basically has the same two. They're just slightly different. One, she turns and goes. The other, she just goes forward. We'll start with Tiffany Stratton. She looks kind of like a generic superstar, but keep in mind, she's from NXT, and so she's developing her character. But as far as in the game, she just looks like a generic superstar. She doesn't have the same outfit as her render there. But her render is pretty neutral. She could be a heel or a face, so that's pretty cool. But she does have a new move in the Corksaw Stratton Bomb, which is pretty decent. So if you don't like her, you could add that to your own custom character. I guess a decent start. This year, a lot of NXT superstars are getting representation. I've only seen her wrestle once. She was okay. I didn't think she was nearly all that. She's got to sharpen her skills. But as far as her entrance and everything, a lot of it's just kind of meh. Elton Prince. His finishers are very basic and stuff. That's why I didn't really show them off. I mean, here you got the Big Boot 10. But their actual tag team moves are really cool. Their taunts are definitely better than Stratton and Luke Gallows. I feel like they really went in with it with the taunts and such as far as the Pretty Deadly team. Although I will say their renders could have been a little better. And it's simply because some of these look like cardboard. It's weird. Like you look at this. This looks so out of place on a match card. But this doesn't. This looks solid. So other than that, decent. Carl Anderson and Luke Gallows. They're solid in every part of this update, in my opinion. Because the renders are absolutely insane. You can use them as face or heels, and you can separate them and have them go on their own individual runs. Their moves are kind of the same, although they did update Luke Gallows. Definitely cool. It doesn't feel like they just threw these guys back in the game. I'm going to say that for sure. The only thing it feels like they could have done better with the Good Brothers, the OC, whatever you want to call them, is the taunts. The taunts, from what I could tell, and from what it said was new, aren't new. So that's kind of disappointing, but I look at it like this. That's the only way they're disappointing. They have a new entrance. I also want to point out that I do really like their Titantrons and all this stuff right here, but I actually want to look at their single entrances here. Just to see if there's any pyro or anything special. Alright, there is. See, that's solid. You can really, really use this. And he's got more than one entrance, too. I like that. Let's see what his other one is. I'm pretty sure it's just like his old entrance. Yeah. It's just his old entrance. Yeah, they did really good with the pyro in this. And they kept the old stuff in. So, see, that's been a reoccurring problem in the game, is they'll add something new, but they'll get rid of the old. With the OC, they haven't really done that. They've give them new things, new entrances, and new moves and stuff, but they didn't really get rid of the old at all. It's still there if you want to revert back to the stuff you liked in 2K20 or 2K19. I think the reason they updated them all was for the pyro, and I'm going to be honest. They have pyro with each of their single entrances, and then they have pyro with their tag entrance, and then they have pyro with their trio tag entrance. That's why they updated it. They really wanted to show off the pyro, which I know it's going to sound weird, but for that reason alone, and because of how good it looks with the Titantron, with the video, with the music, with the new animations, and then with the pyro, I got to say, the best part about this update is the OC. Yeah, if I had to rate the best things out of this update, the OC would be at the top. Then maybe I'd go to Pretty Deadly, honestly. Overall, I think it's a solid update. I don't know if I'd say it was better than the other one. And the other one, we had the Steiners, and we had Hit Row, and we had a manager. So we only had four. And this one, we have five. But like I said, Tiffany Stratton doesn't really stand out. I feel like we could have got Tiffany Stratton literally off of Community Creations. Comment down below, how did you feel about everyone in this pack? What was your favorite? What was your least favorite? What do you agree with? What do you disagree with? Let me know down in the comments. Leave a like if you enjoyed this full DLC review. Subscribe for more. And until next time, keep the attitude.